Document Studio is a versatile Google add-on that helps you automate your work with the help of Google Sheets and Google Forms. My name is Amit Agarwal. I'm the developer of Document Studio. I've also been awarded the title of Google Developer Expert and Google Cloud Innovator for my work across the Google platform. The first version of Document Studio launched in 2017, and it was originally designed to help you generate documents and send emails. We have completely rewritten the add-on, and it now helps you do a lot more things, including the ability to generate certificates, payment invoices. You can send text messages. You can send messages to Slack. You can create tasks inside Trello, and so much more. We take your privacy very seriously. The source code of Document Studio has been audited by Bishop Fox, a security assessment vendor appointed by Google, and is 100% compliant with Google API policies. To get started, visit documentstudio.pro and click this blue install button to install the add-on in your Google account. The add-on will never store, share, or upload any of your data, and everything stays in your Google account. In this tutorial, we will build an employee onboarding workflow with the help of Document Studio. We would send personalized offer letters to new employees. This email would also include an employee badge with their photograph and a QR code or a barcode, all generated with Document Studio. We would also share a Google Drive folder with them that includes onboarding material, including the employee handbook, the company's remote work policy, and other documents. So let's get started now. So here we have a Google Sheet that contains the details of candidates who have been hired recently, and we'll use Document Studio to send them personalized offer letters and other documents. The first row of the Google Sheet contains the column titles or headers, and the candidate data is from row 2 onwards. We have the employee ID, their full name, their manager's name, position, salary, their email address, where the offer letters would be sent, and the profile picture. Now this salary column is in number format, so let me quickly convert it into currency format. Now these profile pictures of new hires are stored in our Google Drive, and we can simply put the link of the file in the sheet if we are to embed any of these photographs in the generated documents. We will actually use these photographs to generate employee photo badges. Now that our input data is ready in Google Sheets, let's create a template in Google Docs for generating the offer letters. We're using Google Docs to create the template for this example, but you can also use Google Slides or Google Sheets for creating document templates. This document template is made up of two types of content. There is static content, which is fixed, and then there is dynamic content that is customized for each recipient. For instance, in this document template, the placeholder employee name, which is enclosed inside double curly braces, is dynamic. Now, anything that is inside these template tags will be replaced with actual data that can come from either Google Sheets or Google Form responses. I'll also add a signature to this document and maybe format this text using one of those cursive fonts to make the text look like a signature. Please ensure that your placeholders inside the document template exactly match the column titles in the Google Sheet. For instance, in this document template, we have a salary placeholder. But if you switch to the Google Sheet, you will notice that the column title is actually gross salary. So we will have to change the text in the document template from salary to gross salary, otherwise the mapping may not work. Next, we'll create a template inside Google Slides for generating the employee photo badges. Thank you. Now the first text box will hold the employee's name. So let's change the font and maybe choose a different background color. Inside this text box, we will add the employee name placeholder again enclosed inside double curly braces, and this will be replaced with the actual values from the Google Sheet. The second text box will be used for adding the employee ID to the photo badge. Now we will add another text box for embedding the employee's photo from Google Drive into the badge. We'll use a special tag called embed image, and this instructs Document Studio to replace the placeholder with an image and not plain text. So the syntax for embedding an image is very simple. You just start double curly braces, then write embed image, comma, and then the quotient title or the column title from the sheet that contains the profile picture. Document Studio will try to fit the image inside the text box, but you can set the mode to crop and it will scale and center the image to fit the bounds of the original shape. Now, similar to embedding images, for QR code we have the special syntax called embed QR code, and this is followed by the quotient title or the column that contains the text for the QR code. Now you can also change the width of the QR code, the background color, the foreground color, but for this example just stick to the default values. Now that our source data and document templates are ready, let's launch Document Studio. Open the Google Sheet that contains the employee data. Go to the Extensions menu and choose Document Studio and click Open. Now if you do not see the Document Studio menu in your Extensions menu, please visit documentstudio.pro and install the add-on and then reload the sheet. Everything in Document Studio is a workflow, and each workflow can accomplish many things. If you're just getting started, you may check out some of these pre-built workflows, but for this example, we will build a new workflow from scratch. Click the Create Workflow button and give your workflow a meaningful name that describes what this workflow does. Next, choose the sheet that contains the source data. Now you may choose to run this workflow for all rows in your Google Sheet or only rows that match certain criteria. For instance, I can say that this workflow should process rows where the manager's name contains either Alex or Angus. I can also add multiple conditions, like I may wish to skip sending offer letters to candidates that have engineer as the position. Again, to keep things simple, let's process all rows of the sheet and send offer letters to everyone listed in the sheet. Now this takes us to the task screen where we will define what the workflow will actually do with the source data, that is in Google Sheets. For the first task, we will choose the Create File task. We'll select the document template that contains the offer letter. Now this Google File Picker has three sections: Documents, Spreadsheets and Presentations. Now since our template is of type document, we will switch to the document section. As soon as you select the document template, you will see a list of all markers that are available inside your template. Now this is a good way to verify that all the placeholder tags inside your template are correctly getting read by the add-on. Next, we'll choose the parent Google Drive folder where all the generated documents would be saved. Now you may choose to store documents in your Google Drive or even a shared drive. You can also specify subfolder inside the main folder where the documents are stored, and this list of subfolders can be dynamic as well. For instance, if you want to store all offer letters for one position in a specific folder, you can put position enclosed inside double curly braces and it creates a subfolder with that name. You can also put a slash and add another subfolder inside that, and so on. Next, we'll provide the name of the generated documents. Again, this can be dynamic, so if we put employee name enclosed inside double curly braces, the file name would be the same as the employee name. Now you may skip putting the extension here, since the export format that we will choose in the next step will determine what the file extension should be. All documents generated by Document Studio are stored in your Google Drive, but they can also be shared with other people as soon as they are added in your Drive. For instance, if I want to share the documents as soon as they are generated with our HR, I can just put their email address here. Now these emails can again be dynamic. So if I put email address enclosed inside double curly braces, the file would be shared with the actual email address that is specified in the Google Sheet. So a basic configuration is done. Next, click the preview button to test if the task has been configured correctly. Now, when you click the preview button, it generates sample data for every column in your spreadsheet using the data that's in row number 2 of your sheet. You can obviously override this data with your own for testing. Now, let's click the test button and it should generate a sample document in your Google Drive. Everything looks good. The placeholders in the document template have been correctly replaced with the data from Google Sheets. The only problem is that the start date is not populated, and the reason is that we do not have a start date column in our Google Sheets. So I can quickly add it with some sample data. Now let's add another task that will generate the photo badges for each employee. Now we'll again choose the create file task. This time we'll choose the template that we created inside Google Slides. And quickly fill in all the other fields. I'll put these generated photo badges under the badges folder in the main employees directory. We can save these badges as PDF or PNG, but I'll choose PDF for this example. The configuration is almost done, so let's quickly generate a test badge with the sample data. And there you have the badge with the profile picture, the QR code, the employee name, and the employee ID. We are done generating the documents, but we would also like to send the offer letters in an email to the candidate. So we'll choose the Add Another Task option and choose the task Send Email. Now you can send emails via your Gmail account, but we also support other mail service providers including Amazon SES and SendGrid. Let's go with Gmail since it is already part of your Google account. You need to put the sender's name and your sender's email address. You can send emails on behalf of any email address that is added as an alias to your Gmail account. Now, since we want to send an email to the employee's email address, we'll choose the column title that contains the candidate's email address. Next, specify the email recipients in the two CC and BCC fields. Now, if you want to add unique email addresses in the CC or BCC fields, you can create a column in the Google Sheet with those addresses and use that column title in the CC field. Next, we'll specify the email subject line, and these can again include placeholders. I'll quickly type the email body here, and again, this can be personalized using data from Google Sheets. Now, this email would also link to a folder in our Google Drive that contains all the policy documents. So I can grab that link from Google Drive and create a link inside the email pointing to that folder. I'll share a new feature of Document Studio here. Now, if you say dear employee name, it will print the full name of the employee in the email message. But let's say you only wish to use the employee's first name here. Now, there are two ways of doing this. We can either create a new column in Google Sheets, titled say employee first name, and then use some sort of a formula that extracts the first name from the full name. And we will then use this new column instead of the employee name placeholder in our email message. The other option is that we use scriptlets. This is a special templating language that lets you manipulate strings inside email messages in Document Studio. You can learn more about scriptlets in our documentation, but for this example, our scriptlet would look something like this. We take the employee name, whatever is the value of the employee name, we split that value with a space, and we get an array, and then we print the first element of that array, and that is the first name. This next checkbox is important because if you are generating any files in your workflow, like in our case, we are generating the employee offer letter as well as the photo badge, and you would like to attach those documents to the email message, you should check this option. All good, you can click this preview button to test how your final email would look like in the recipient's inbox. Now we will add one more task, and that is to share the company's handbook and other policy documents with the new employees. For that, we will choose the Google Drive task. Now here you can use this task to copy files, create new folders or share files. We will choose the share folder option because we want to share the entire folder with the new employees. Next, choose the folder in Google Drive that contains the documents that you would like to share with the new employees. Now, since we would like to add the new employees as viewers to this folder, you can put their email address in the viewers input box. Now, this email address is dynamic and the value is pulled directly from Google Sheets. So, workflow is complete now. Click continue to move to the next screen where we will set up our triggers. Now you can choose the merge every hour option if you would like this workflow to run in the background and process new rows as they are added to the Google Sheet. You obviously don't want to process any rows that are hidden or filtered in the Google Sheet, so it is a good idea to keep this option checked. The time delay feature in Document Studio allows you to add a time delay and hold the execution of a workflow until a certain time or when a certain condition is met. So, for instance, in this example, if you want to send an offer letter only 30 days after the interview date, you can choose 1 month and then choose the joining date or the interview date from the date field. Coming to our workflow, we want this workflow to run immediately, so I'll uncheck the time delay option and click the save and run option. You will now see a list of rows in the Google Sheet that are available for processing. You can also deselect rows that you do not wish to process in this manual run. Now let's click the Run Workflow button to execute the workflow. The process is now complete, so let's switch to our Gmail and you can see all the emails that have been sent out with Document Studio. Document Studio is versatile and can help you automate your work. You can download the add-on from documentstudio.pro.